side by side, they don't look all that great. Their potential was cut short in a gill net. They are great white sharks, though, and left alone could have grown to more than 20 feet in length, basically the size of a stretch limo with teeth. These are the latest addition to Tom Lewis's growing fish story. He's caught 5 great white sharks in the last 2 weeks and let a 6th go free. They've all been babies. They've all been within a couple of hundred yards of the surf line near Black's Beach in La Jolla.
Doesn't bother me, you know, but I don't know what to do to the people that are swimming in the area. It's pretty close to shore where we've been getting them.
The most reasonable explanation is that San Diego is somewhat of a maternity ward for great white sharks. The big females come down from up north, have their pups, and then the pups spend the next year or two here, feeding and growing. They don't grow all that big in the first couple of years, and they don't feed on humans.
At this size, great white sharks feed on fish. The stomach contents that have been looked at have been small sharks and things like cabazone. They switch over to feeding on marine mammals when they get larger.
They also leave when they get larger. Beachgoers are in more danger from riptides and broken glass than from sharks of any kind. That doesn't mean they're not out there. There are blue sharks, mako sharks, hammerhead sharks, and evidence, as we've seen, that there are plenty of great white sharks in San Diego waters.
I've looked in our records, and in 1955, between the 29th of October and the 12th of November, there were 7 great white sharks of about this size, relatively small ones, caught within a quarter mile of the Scripps Pier.
There has been 1 reported great white shark attack in San Diego. It was 30 years ago, and there are elements of the story which make it suspect.